Welcome to 2022. It is officially the new year, and today we are prepping. Today we are going to get ready for the new year. We're going to prep, we're going to clean, we're going to set intentions, and we're just going to get ourselves physically and mentally ready for the start of 2022. Come along with me to prep for the new year. Hopefully this gives you guys some inspiration to do it for yourself, clean your space, get your head ready for the new year, set your intentions and your goals, because this is gonna be a good year for you guys, for me. We are going to do great this year. Let's set ourselves up for a great year today. So first things first, we are cleaning my room. I am not specifically a neat freak, but I do enjoy my room being very clean. My mental health quite a bit relies on my room being clean. I'm not sure exactly why, but my room is like a little bit messy. It's not terrible, but it needs some work. My mom got me some beautiful Palo Santo for Christmas, and that's what we're going to be using to cleanse the energy in my room. So we are going to get rid of all the negative energy from 2021 so that we have room for the positive energy in 2022. So I have this prayer. It says, "Into this smoke I release all energies that do not serve me, all negativity that surrounds me, and all fears that limit me." So you just say this as you cleanse your room and get rid of all that negative energy. All right, let's light her up. You just burn it and you let it light for like a good 30 seconds and then blow it out. And there we go, we have smoke. use Palo Santo, use sage, light some candles, and you will kind of feel that the vibe of your home or your room will kind of shift. Things will feel a lot lighter, a lot cleaner, and it smells good, so like that's a plus. We have my room all clean, it's all nice and clean, and it feels so good. Trust me, if you guys are looking for a way to start off your new year on the right track, I recommend cleaning out your space, doing some organizing, and just getting rid of the old and bringing in the new for the new year. It is hard to go all in on a certain lifestyle as soon as it hits January 1st. Sometimes it's unrealistic and some of our goals are really high. So when we fail at those goals, we become really discouraged. I wanted to set some intentions with you guys, realistic intentions. One of my big goals is journaling every day. I want to try my best to do it and we'll see how that goes. If you guys are looking for a way to help your mental health and you have not tried journaling, I would definitely recommend it. It's not for everyone, but I enjoy it. So this is my journal. It says create your own happiness, which I thought is really sweet. This journal is pretty filled, which I'm proud of. I like to write down things that I'm grateful for. I like to manifest in my journals. I like to just give myself good energy in my journal entries. I also found that I'm not good at journaling every day, but I want to journal every day. So that's where the 5-minute journal comes into play. It is a formatted journal that you just follow along. It's very easy, very simple, and it allows you to do your journaling in under 5 minutes every single day. So it asks you questions like, what are you grateful for? What would make today great? And it tells you to give yourself a daily affirmation. I want to try to do this every single day for the new year. I feel like it could really help me, especially because I love journaling. Plus, I don't always have time to do it every single day. This, being only 5 minutes, will help me do it every day. I want to read a book every single month. One book every single month. For you book readers out there, it might not seem like a lot to read only one book every month, but you know, I find myself very busy with college and with YouTube and with social life that I don't have enough time to read a book. And I want to make the time to read at least one book every month. So I'm going to try to read a book every month for my mental health, for my well-being. So some of my fitness goals, it wouldn't be New Year's without some sort of fitness goal, am I right? I feel like everyone has some sort of fitness goal. For me, my fitness goals this year is to get a push-up, like a really strong, well-rounded, perfect form push-up. I don't have it yet. I really don't, but I'm going to get it. Number two, I want to get a pull-up. So like a perfect pull-up. I want to be able to have the strength to do at least one perfect form pull-up. And then number three, I want to learn to do a pistol squat. So I have not been able to do a pistol squat. These are really difficult for some reason. And I want to be able to gain the strength to do it. Get a push-up, get a pull-up, and be able to do a pistol squat are my main fitness goals for the next year. Those are very hard movements for me, and once I'm able to do them, I'll feel very strong, I will feel very proud, and it will probably take my fitness level to a higher level. I recommend if you guys are making fitness goals for yourself to focus more on the strength aspect. Try to focus on being healthy. Don't focus so much on the weight. Don't focus so much on the aesthetics. Focus on what makes you feel good. Me being strong and feeling strong makes me feel good. These three exercises that I'm aiming for, once I get them, will make me feel really good. They will make me feel really strong and proud of myself. There's gonna be a lot of fun opportunities. A lot of good things are coming your way. Just keep believing in yourself. All right, guys, so once again, Happy New Year. I will see you guys next video. Bye.